Now in this section we are going to derive about the wave modes and the gain of traveling wave tube. So up till now we have seen the operation of traveling wave tube, about the slow wave structures, that is we have used a helical wave structure in a traveling wave tube, the significance of using it, how a signal is getting amplified in a traveling wave tube, and we have also seen about the derivations of convection current and axial electric field in traveling wave tube. This section we will see how the wave modes and gain of traveling wave tube is being derived. Now we are familiar with these two types of equation, that is the circuit equation which we have obtained from the derivation of axial electric field, that is we have seen how the axial electric field is affected by the spatial AC electron beam current small I. This is a AC electron beam current. So how it is going to affect our axial electric field, that was seen in the circuit equation or on the derivation of the axial electric field. We have also come across a derivation of convection current, okay, in which we have seen an electronic equation, that is we determined how the convection current, that is small I, is induced by the axial electric field, that is capital E1. So these two equations are going to help us in finding the wave modes. Simultaneously we have to solve this electronic equation and circuit equation, that is in this first equation instead of I you can substitute the second equation. That is what we are going to do in the next step to proceed with our calculation of wave modes. Now while substituting the second equation in the first equation, that is instead of I in the first equation we have substituted with the value of I in the second equation, that is simultaneously taking the electronic equation and the circuit equation and getting the equation number 3. Now see the equation number 3, we are going to determine about the wave modes. Okay, from this equation we can see that it is a fourth order in terms of propagation constant of axial waves. We know gamma is representing the propagation constant. Okay, so this equation is a fourth order equation, which means what? There will be four possible solutions which are called as wave modes. So we can conclude that we may be having four different mode of propagation since we are having four propagation constants. So it is actually difficult to solve the fourth order equation. Since it is a fourth order equation, it can be solved by numerical methods and a digital computer. However, approximation can be done by equating the DC electron beam velocity to the velocity of the axial wave. Now, we are making an assumption that let our velocity of the axial wave and the electron beam be equal. Then we could find some approximate solution for our wave modes. Okay, so if we are setting, say, the axial velocity of the wave to the velocity of the electron, that is Vp is equal to Ve. We know the velocity of the equation as V is equal to omega by beta. So if the velocities are equal, which means what? This beta will also be equal. Okay, so phase constant beta P will be equal to beta E. And we know this propagation constant gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta. Now usually for higher frequency we neglect alpha and we take only this j beta. So since these velocities are equal, we can approximate our gamma naught to be equal to j into beta e. That is the beta p is beta e. Okay. So we can take approximation that let gamma naught is equal to j beta e for finding the approximate solution for our propagation modes. Now by setting of gamma naught is equal to j beta e, we can find out the approximate solution. So why we have taken this gamma naught to be equal to j beta e, I have already stated. So in this equation, somehow we want to find the solution for gamma. Okay, so it is actually not possible to find the exact solution. For time being, we make an assumption and set gamma naught is equal to j beta e. So while substituting gamma naught is equal to j beta e, Here I have shown how the equation turns out to be. Okay, so finally we get a equation as such. This is our fourth equation. How I have written this equation, you might have understood, that is, this particular equation is a square minus b square. This term, this is a square minus b square, which could be written as a plus b into a minus of b. Okay, so we will be having gamma minus j beta e into gamma plus j beta e. So this gamma plus j beta e is taken here, and gamma minus j beta e, it is going to become the whole cube. Okay, so we have written as such our fourth equation. And here we have to remember a very important parameter. Like the bunging parameter we have taken in klystron, or our cyclotron angular frequency we have considered in magnetron, in traveling wave tube we have to remember this is a very important parameter, that is a traveling wave tube gain parameter, which is defined as follows. I naught is a naught by 4 V naught the whole raised to 1 by 3. So remembering this parameter, traveling wave gain parameter, is very important in our analysis. Okay, so we can see in our fourth equation this term C is appearing. That is, I naught is a naught by 4 V naught. If we are going to replace it with our C, the equation turns out to be, here this term is CQ. So how can we modify this equation? It becomes in the RHS, it becomes 2 C cube beta E square gamma square. So this is our fifth equation. So here we have replaced gamma naught by J beta E and written the equation, and then considered the traveling wave gain parameter and further replaced this equation with C and obtained the fifth equation. Now continuing with our fifth equation. Now just observe the fifth equation. Okay, what we understand from this, there are to the power of 3, there are 3 waves. Okay, so we know these 3 waves may be a forward traveling waves with e raised to minus of j beta e z. Okay, and this will be a backward traveling wave, say with e raised to j beta e z. That is a conclusion we could draw obviously from the fifth equation. That is, there could be 3 forward traveling waves and there could be a 1 wave which is traveling in the backward or negative z direction from this expression, since it is positive j beta e. Now earlier we have taken gamma naught to be equal to j beta e. Now we are having what? 3 forward traveling waves. Now let the propagation constant gamma be equal to j beta e minus of beta e c delta, where it is assumed that c delta is very much lesser than 1. That is, initial case we have taken gamma naught as j beta e. Now for the 3 forward traveling waves, this j beta e minus beta e, that is a propagation constant, multiplied by the traveling wave tube parameter into a constant delta is taken. Okay, so we are doing this for what? Somehow we have to find the approximate solutions for gamma. So in this equation we could replace gamma by this particular term. So and further solving we get the equation as such. Okay, so when simplifying, obviously in this term j beta e and minus j beta e goes, and we get only minus beta e c delta the whole cube, and here we get 2 j beta e minus beta e c delta is equal to 2 c cube beta e square into, and expanding this a minus b the whole square, you get this particular term. Now we have made an assumption that this c delta which we have taken is very much less, it is very much lesser than 1. So in this particular equation we could neglect some terms since the c delta is lesser than 1. So we have simplified it and written this particular expression. So in this I could neglect this particular term, okay, beta e c delta, since c delta is very much lesser than 1. So in the LHS side you get only this particular term, and here also wherever c delta is coming we could neglect these two terms. So we will get here only minus 2 c cube beta e raised to 4. Okay, so from this particular equation we could obtain the value of delta. Okay, what do we get delta? from this particular equation we get the value of delta to be the value of the delta from this particular equation is got to be delta cube is equal to 1 by j, which could be written as minus j. So what do we get the value of delta? Delta we get it as minus j the whole raised to 1 by 3. So in this equation we have made a conclusion that there is 3 forward traveling wave and 1 backward traveling wave. For the 3 forward traveling wave we have taken the propagation constant gamma as such, okay, and after substituting and making, then we are going to get the value for delta as minus j the whole raised to 1 by 3. So continuing here with delta is equal to minus j the whole raised to 1 by 3. It could also be expressed as e raised to minus j into pi by 2 plus 2n pi by 3, where n is varying from 0, 1, 2. Why 0, 1, 2? Because we are having only 3 forward traveling waves. We are going to find the approximate propagation constant values first of all for the 3 forward traveling waves. Okay, so this could also be expressed as e raised to minus j into pi plus 4n pi by 6. Okay, if we are solving this. So this equation is very important. We have to understand this equation to get the further solution. So by solving, we got delta is equal to minus j the whole raised to 1 by 3, which could also be further expressed as such for n varying from 0, 1, 2. So in this general equation of delta, now we have to find the three roots. First case for n is equal to 0, second case for n is equal to 1, and third case for n is equal to 2. So first for n is equal to 0, what will be delta 1? Substituting n is equal to 0 in this, we get e raised to minus j pi by 6. We know how it could be solved further. It will be sin pi by 6 minus j sin pi by 6. Okay, that is how we got root of 3 by 2 minus j into sin pi by 6, that is 1 by 2. So this is the first value of delta 1. So what will be the corresponding gamma 1? J beta e minus c into delta 1, we have taken gamma 1. So substituting the value of delta 1 here, we get the approximate value for gamma 1 as such. Okay. Similarly, we have to find the roots of other forward traveling waves. Similarly, the second root delta 2 at n is equal to 1. When we are substituting n is equal to 1 in the equation, we get the value to be e raised to minus j 5 pi by 6. Okay. So we get the value as such for the delta 2. So again we have to see what is gamma 2 while we are substituting the value of delta 2 as such. So we get an expression for gamma 2 to be as such. Again the third forward traveling wave, similarly find for the others. For n is equal to 2, what will be delta 3 and what will be the corresponding value of gamma 3. Now we have a backward traveling wave. So we could set the gamma to be j beta e minus beta e c delta 4, that is the fourth root which we have to find now. So instead of positive j beta e, here we have made a replacement of minus j beta e. Okay, so similarly find what is the value of corresponding delta 4 and what will be the corresponding value of gamma 4. So when asked to explain about the wave modes in traveling wave tube for the examination, you could show for two roots. Okay, we can solve it and show for two roots and write similarly for the other, since it's a very much lengthy derivation. And the most important part is to understand about the nature of these waves. What is the nature of the forward traveling, or whether it is backward traveling or forward traveling, and what is the nature of the propagation modes in traveling wave tube, which is explained in the subsequent section. Now, to understand about the nature of propagation modes is important to draw a conclusion about what type of waves are traveling in the helical wave tube. Now we have seen that there are four solutions for gamma. Okay, there three may be forward traveling wave and one a backward traveling wave. Now we have to draw some conclusion about these gamma values which we have obtained. Okay. Obviously, these four propagation constants are going to represent four different propagation modes in helix traveling wave tube. That is the first conclusion. Okay, now we will take one by one the values of gamma and draw a conclusion. So first taking the gamma 1, in general in electromagnetics, how could the wave be represented? It is represented as e raised to minus of gamma into z, where z is the direction of propagation of wave. Okay, so one by one we'll consider the values of gamma. So first case, e raised to minus of gamma 1 is it, and substituting the value of gamma here, obviously this has to multiply by z. Okay, so when we are writing as e raised to minus of this gamma 1, this is a gamma 1, what we get, we find that obviously a wave is traveling in positive z direction. Since it is of the form e raised to minus of j beta e, so when we multiply this by z, e raised to minus j beta e z. So minus j beta e z represents a positive z direction. If it is e raised to plus j beta e z, it will be in the negative z direction. So here it is minus j beta e, it is in the positive z direction. When we multiply by z, it is in positive z direction. And what we understand here about the amplitude, it is a exponentially growing wave. Okay, so the first one represents a wave in the forward direction with growing amplitude. That is, it is an exponentially growing wave as such shown in the figure. And another thing to observe about this wave is that it is propagating with the phase velocity lower than that of the electron beam velocity. Okay. It is actually exponentially growing wave, but the velocity is lower than that of the electron beam velocity. So the energy has to flow here from the electron beam to that of the wave. So these are the conclusions drawn about the first propagation mode in traveling wave tube. So again we have to consider the other propagation constants, that is gamma 2, gamma 3, gamma 4, etc. So when we consider about the second propagation constant gamma 2, okay, and expressing it in the exponential form of wave, now we observe that this is also what, it is in the form e raised to minus of j beta e, propagation is z. So if you are multiplying with z, e raised to minus j beta e z, this is also traveling in the forward direction. But how is the amplitude part here? It is decaying, e raised to minus of root 3 by 2 beta e into c. So this is a decaying amplitude wave. Okay, it is exponentially decaying. So the wave traveling in forward direction with decaying exponential amplitude. Okay, and the another conclusion made about this wave is that the velocity with which this decaying wave propagates is approximately same as that of the growing wave which we have seen. But the energy here flows in the reverse way. That is, from the wave, it goes to the electron beam. So here it is decaying and finally it almost diminishes, and the energy here is flowing here from the wave, it is transferred to the electron beam. In the previous case, the growing amplitude, the energy was getting transferred from the electron beam to the wave, and the wave was getting increased amplitude with increase in time. Here the energy flows from the wave to the electron beam. That is the conclusion about the second propagation mode in traveling wave tube. Now about the third forward traveling wave, gamma 3. Okay, so it can be expressed as e raised to minus gamma 3 of z. Now when we are substituting the value of propagation constant gamma, we observe that it is obviously a forward traveling wave by the representation. But there is no sign of amplitude here, whether it is growing or decaying. So it can be a constant amplitude. So third one is a wave in forward direction with a constant amplitude. And the constant amplitude wave is traveling with a velocity slightly higher than the electron beam velocity. So the electron velocity is lesser than that of this particular wave. It is growing little faster. But in this case, this constant amplitude wave, we find that there is no energy transfer occurring between the electron beam and wave. That is, there is no interaction for this constant amplitude wave. Now regarding the fourth propagation constant, so when we are writing it as e raised to minus gamma 4 of z, we observe that it becomes in the form e raised to positive j beta e z. So it is a backward traveling wave, which is traveling in the negative z direction. So it is since which is of the form e raised to j beta z. Okay, so fourth one is a backward traveling wave with the constant amplitude. There is no sign of amplitude increasing or decreasing. So it is a constant amplitude wave. And this wave is going to propagate with a velocity slightly higher than that of the velocity of electron beam. Now, this type of backward traveling wave tube, it can be prevented. That is by using of an attenuator. So, already in the diagram for traveling wave tube, we have seen that we are using an attenuator at the center of the tube. So, these type of waves are usually absorbed with the help of attenuator. It is not a preferred wave. Only the forward traveling waves are preferred. The backward traveling waves are not preferred at the operation. So these waves can be attenuated by using attenuator at the center of the tube. So now we have understood about the four types of propagation constant, about the four modes of propagation in helical traveling wave tube. Now we have obtained the approximate solutions for the propagation constants of gamma. Okay, I have written this once more of gamma because it is very important to remember these formulas while doing the numericals. There will be direct substitution. So remembering the values of four propagation constant, gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3 and gamma 4 is important. So learn this. Okay, these are important. So we have now concluded about the four propagation constant and the nature of these four propagation constants in detail. Remembering these values of gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, gamma 4 is very important. Now we'll see about the gain of traveling wave tube, or on what parameters the traveling wave tube gain depends on. Okay, so this is our helical structure. Obviously, we are going to apply our RF input here and get our amplified RF output here on this particular length. And it is in the positive z direction. We take the length L to be expressed as n into lambda e, where lambda e is the electronic wavelength and n is the number of cycles in this length. So L could be expressed as a multiplication of n and lambda e. So we could also write the voltage at the z length. This is the z length of helix as V1 e raised to minus gamma 1 z plus V2 e raised to minus gamma 2 z plus V3 e raised to minus gamma 3 z. Obviously, these three are forward traveling waves and we are having one backward traveling wave V4 e raised to gamma 4 z. Now, we are going to place an attenuator at the center of the helix. So, we can neglect this backward. That is, we assume that the structure is perfectly matched and we consider only the three forward traveling waves. So if at here this is V0 is V1 plus V2 plus V3, we neglect the V4 wave. Now for a derivation for the gain of traveling wave tube, for simplifying, we assume that our voltage values V1, V2 and V3 is equal to V0 divided by 3, that is equally distributed between the three forward traveling waves. Okay, so if this is our input voltage and output voltage V0 of z is represented as V1 e raised to minus of gamma 1 z. Here z and the length L which we consider is the same. And substituting the value for our propagation constant gamma 1, we can write the expression for V0 of L as such. Now since we have taken this V1 to be equal to V0 divided by 3, V0 of L could be expressed as such as shown here. From the expression of V0 of L, if I am taking the magnitude, neglecting the imaginary part, I get the expression as such. Now in this, I am going to introduce my L factor. L we have taken as n into lambda e. So for that substitution, instead of beta e L, I can substitute here as 2 pi n. That is, we have known that beta e is 2 pi by lambda e. Okay, so multiplying LHS and RHS by L, we get beta e L to be equal to 2 pi into n. So in this expression, instead of beta e L, we can replace it with 2 pi n. So we get the magnitude of V0 of L as such. Okay, so again, we have to proceed with this value of V0 of L. So now we got a simplified expression for the magnitude of V naught of L. Now our intention is to find out the power gain in dB, the power of the traveling wave too. So the power in dB could be found out by taking 10 log into what? The output divided by the input. Here our input was also V naught, and output we have got the V naught of L expression. So by substituting this and simplifying, we will get the power in dB. The steps are shown here. All these steps are shown for better understanding. Go through it. So solving, we get the power in dB as follows. Okay, so what conclusion we can draw from this power of the traveling wave tube? We observe that initially there is a loss of minus 9.54. The output power gain indicates an initial loss at the circuit input of 9.54 dB. So initially there is a loss. Why could be the problem? The problem is because the input voltage is splitting into three waves of equal magnitude. Okay, so we are having three forward traveling waves and it is equally splitting into three, and the growing wave voltage is only 1/3 of the total input voltage. We have only got one mode which is of growing amplitude. So it is only 1/3 of the total input voltage. That may be the reason why there is an initial loss of 9.54 dB. Okay, again we observe that the power gain is proportional to the length n in electronic wavelength of the slow wave structure and the gain parameter C of the circuit. So the gain is also depending upon the factors n and C, where C is the traveling wave tube gain parameter and n is the length, electronic length of the structure, slow wave structure. So in this section we have derived about the wave modes. We have understood about the nature of the propagation constants, that is the nature of wave modes which is existing in the traveling wave tube. And we have seen that by using an attenuator, we are almost neglecting the backward traveling wave. And then we have seen the value for the gain of the traveling wave tube. We have seen about the power in dB and made a conclusion. So by now, we have understood fully about the working of the traveling wave O-type tube amplifier.